I don't want to do the same thing every day. What can I do that has lots of variety?
I've done science A-levels, but I don't want to be a scientist. What can I do with them?
If you're at that stage of your life and you're making decisions on what you want to do with your career, environmental health is absolutely a great career to have.
We inspect food premises, whether they're shops or schools or hospitals or catering vehicles or food stalls at festivals or markets. We inspect houses to see that they're fit, and if they're not fit, we take action to make them fit. We get involved with pollution, so that's noise pollution, it may be water pollution, it may be air pollution. We get involved in licensing activities. There's an awful lot done by environmental health officers.
I was one of those people who was very outdoorsy, very outgoing, didn't want to spend the rest of my life in an office, wanted to help the wider community.
I originally started a biology degree at university, realised that wasn't for me, and decided to go out into the big world and get a job.
I saw an opportunity in an advert for environmental health, and when I read up in it, I couldn't believe it. All my dreams of what I'd wanted and aspired to be were all wrapped up in this environmental health career.
I ended up working in waste management, and it was because of that job in waste management that I met some environmental health officers and decided at that point that that was something I was interested in, and I went back to university and I retrained and I qualified as an environmental health officer some 4 years later.
After I'd qualified, I worked in general public health in a local authority for a period of time. Then I moved into food, health and safety and infectious disease control, and that's where I found my real love, the actual infectious disease, about protecting the community, protecting people's health.
I don't want to be stuck in the office all day.
As an environmental health officer, the vast majority of my time was out of the office.
I think if you speak to any EHO, you'll find that the diversity of the role is what's appealing.
No 2 days were ever the same. Right from day one, I was getting to make my own decisions, going out, doing inspections, finding things wrong, serving notices, working with people to make things right, and helping people.
I used to love going out on district and meeting people and hearing their stories. Everybody's just got an interesting story to tell you, and that was great.
As I got more experienced, I started to manage a small team, and we were able to take on bigger projects, and I found that very rewarding. You could identify something that you could do something about it, and you could stand back and you'd say, I did that, I made a difference to those people's lives. And that's really very gratifying.
I like the idea of environmental health, but I don't want to work for the council.
Starting off my career in local government gave me the absolute foundation to take forward into the world of consultancy and then into the world of private sector.
There are lots of places where you will find environmental health officers. You find them traditionally in big retailers. We've got environmental health officers working for the coffee chains generally, View Cinema, Moto Group, working in the big corporate caterers, people like Compass Group. We had a huge team of EHOs working at the London Olympics, making sure that everything was safe. There are EHOs working across the rail network. There are EHOs working for holiday companies, making sure that locations to which people go abroad are safe. You find them working in health and safety groups, where they do occupational health as well as protect health and safety of the public. A large music venue or a venue that's used for sport like Silverstone or the O2 or Glastonbury, you will find that you're working at those events, checking for public safety, checking the food stalls, checking for noise. Agencies such as the Environment Agency, the NHS, We have environmental health officers working in government across England, Wales and Northern Ireland, working for charities, so helping the homeless, working abroad in disaster areas.
Hiya, John Hi. Clements from the Council for Environmental Health.
Yeah.
Come to have a look at the property. I believe you've got some problems here.
John Clements and his colleagues inspect around 150 properties a year in the Torvine Council area.
Is that acceptable for anyone to be living in conditions like that?
From our point of view, no, I don't believe it is acceptable.
We often find environmental health officers quoted in the media. You need a whole range of skills for this job, and communications is just one of them. A lot of environmental health practitioners will set themselves up as consultants to work for themselves. There are also opportunities in academia, and you can go and lecture at university. The Army, the Navy and the RAF all have environmental health officers, and they will sponsor those officers through their degree course, and then they go back to the forces where they will practice environmental health, sometimes in a war zone. For instance, there were environmental health officers in Afghanistan.
Environmental health officers have brilliant skills, and those skills are transferable to lots of different professions and lots of different environments. I, for one, have had stepping stone into the civil service and now into the NHS.
I want to do a job where I help people.
We are used to dealing with the public on a day-to-day basis. We are used to dealing with everything that the public throw at us. And I think that stands you in good stead for public health as well. Public health is all about protecting the population. We don't treat people like doctors and clinicians do. Instead of curing people once they've become ill, our job is to prevent them becoming ill in the first place. So instead of treating somebody who's obese, we try to prevent them becoming obese in the first place. Another area of public health that people would be involved in is physical activity and nutrition. The smoking rate in the UK is higher than we would like it to be. Alcohol and binge drinking. We have a lot of substance misuse. And when you understand the population from your time as an environmental health officer, it makes that job a lot easier.
We employ about 55,000 people in the UK and Ireland, and we work across a whole range of business sectors. It could be healthcare, defence, leisure. We are predominantly known as a contract caterer, but we provide a lot of support services as well. The event today, we'll have an event team on site here in Millennium Stadium today. We're setting up for a Speedway event. Now the stadium itself will be managing most of the heavy duty work that's going on today, but we will be providing services throughout the whole stadium, mainly from catering perspective, but also conferencing, banqueting, hospitality. My role is to run food safety, health and safety, environment management, crisis management, supply chain issues. I would say my favourite part is actually the safety side of things, protecting the workforce and making sure that, you know, we send people home every day in a healthy and safe way is one of my biggest motivators.
How often is the grease filters clean?
Once a week.
Once a week, yeah. And what about the instructions you're taking me on?
That's every 6 months.
Every 6 months.
We'll be in touch. Okay.
Thank you.
No problem.
Right, I'll come back and see you in September, and we'll do both the sites at the same time.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Okay.
I think generally environmental health practitioners are quite outgoing. You have to be, because you're working with people all the time. You have to be a problem solver. You have to be someone who will analyse a situation and decide what the best thing to do is. And you have to have confidence and courage of your convictions, because very often you're making decisions on your own.
There's a lot of private sector business that require can-do people who are prepared at the drop of a hat. You know, going to deal with issues wherever they may be, whichever corners of the world the problems are in.
It's good to be a team player, because you might be working in a team with people who don't want the same things as you do, so you need to be able to negotiate, you need to be able to get involved in discussion and to hold your own in a debate. And someone who is up for a challenge, because every day is different.
People always say to me, gosh, how do you manage that situation? How do you manage to juggle all of those things in one go? And it's because I'm a trained environmental health officer. The skills that you learn as an EHO, you can't learn in other professions, and they stay with you forever.
You're out and about on a daily basis. You're working with a team of professionals, but you make your own decisions and you act on them. You want to work with the public and helping the public. Then this is a job for you.
Bye.